Aquaculture waste often contains uneaten or unabsorbed nutrients, which are lost through waste discharge. In line with circular economy principles, nutrients and wastewater can be used to create valuable co-products that capture the dissolved nitrogen and phosphorus that would otherwise be discarded. Using salmon smolt wastewater for algae production is one example of this. In this type of system, the nutrients in the wastewater are used by the algae for growth. The GAIN project piloted a theoretical open, decoupled aquaponics system that would produce algae from smolt wastewater. They chose a Norwegian circulating aquaculture system, RAS, producing 1,300 tons of smolt per year, and located in the region of Nordland as a representative case for this sector. The algae species chosen is known by the common name sea lettuce. According to the results of the pilot system, a theoretical full-size aquaponic system would successfully manage to recapture up to 71% of the dissolved nitrogen and up to 6% of the dissolved phosphorus deriving from smolt production wastewater. When the system was economically assessed, they found that the system could return a total profit of 300,000 euros per year by selling the high-quality algae to food markets in Asia and the lower-quality algae to the animal feed, fertilizer, and chemical industries. Aside from the potential profit, revised farming licenses or improved regulations could incentivize this type of system that maximizes the use of nutrients, minimizes waste, and increases the efficiency of the food system. The wastewater of this farm contains a yearly load of 3.9 to 5.9 tons of dissolved nitrogen and 2.7 to 4.9 tons of dissolved phosphorus. The production system was drafted for 10-hectare concrete basins with an additional area of 5.5 hectare, producing a total of 1.287 tons of fresh algae per year, equivalent to 109 tons of dry matter. Production period was set from February to October, including 120 days of lower light conditions and 153 days of good light conditions. This system requires an investment of about 2.64 million euros for the production system and equipment, and a total of 16 employees to maintain this labor-intensive system with hand harvesting. A fully distributed cost analysis was conducted based on defined fixed and variable costs. The estimated weighted average returns for the different qualities are 14,000 euros per ton of dry matter, allowing a total profit of 300,000 euros per year. The minimum required product value to achieve cost recovery is 11,000 euros per ton of dry matter.